Welcome everyone to my tutorial, and in this tutorial I will try to explain to you what is the function of shift register. Okay, especially to all students of Unity L, especially to Malaysia France Institute MFI. If you are trying if you are having a difficult time, you know, trying to figure out what is shift register actually, well, I hope this tutorial will make you understand what is the function more clearly. Alright, let's start. Okay, say you are given one push button. Okay, rename it BB1. Then you are going to insert the instruction for the shift register, which is SFT. Now the next thing you're gonna do is you're going, okay, if you're a beginner, if you do not know what to do, okay, I will tell you. It's like this. Go to detail, and it says here that you already selected SFT, the shift register function. The first operand is going to prompt you to enter your starting word, your ST if you are learning PLC. Okay. You're going to put it, okay, let's say I'm going to put it H. Okay, here it says H from 0 to 511 in decimal. That means from 0 to 511, that means it's around 512 bit. Okay, let's say I'm gonna put it N. Okay, the N word is also I'm going to put inside the same word. Let's say, now let's say it's H10. Okay, next I'm going to press OK. Okay, here we go have the data inserts, and this is the pulse while this is the reset. Okay, in this case I'm going to show you the simple way for you to understand shift register. So I'm going to put this another push button, address 0.01 PB2. Right, and for the reset 0.02, and we're gonna name it reset. That's it. We have our first shift register. So you were probably telling yourself why and how does it operate? Okay, it's like this. Inside the shift register, you already place H10. I mean the word H10. It doesn't matter if you put H1, then it's H1. If you put H0.01, maybe you cannot because you already have here 0.01. Okay, I don't want to babble anymore, so I'm going to tell you. Next, you're going to do is you're going to place another contact with H10. Well, the starting word for H10 is 10.00. So you're going to put H10.0. Let's leave it empty. Next, you're going to do is you're going to tell the shift register to give an output to. Okay, we're gonna make a new output of 100, and you're gonna give this out A. Okay, now you have one output. Okay, remember that one word contained 16 bit, so I don't want to go here and do all 16, so I'm just gonna show you a few. Okay, four is enough. The next following is going to put H10.01. Leave it empty. The next one is H10.03. That's it. I have H10, 10.01, 10.02, 10.03. The output, of course, you're going to have to change that. This is going to be your out B, and this is going to be your out C. and this is going to be your out D, right? Okay, right now basically you just completed what I am going to explain to you. Okay, if you're doing this while watching this video, okay, it's going to make you help to learn to understand you more. Okay, let's simulate this. Okay, now PB1, PB2, the reset and all the words are inactive. So what you're going to do here is I want you to press the first push button. Okay, you are already pressing the first push button. Next you are going to do is, okay, you follow what I do. Okay, you press the second push button and you see an output at A. Next, you de-energize PB1 by turning it off. Okay, now I want you to see what this shift register means. Shift register is going to transfer one bit to the left or to the right. Because we are using CX programmer, I don't know whether it is shifting to the left or to the right. But nonetheless, I want you to know what's the function actually. Okay, it's like this. Okay, you off PB2, you keep pressing PB2 repeatedly. Okay, it's like this. Press. Okay, when I press this PB2, I want you to see at this, the output at A. I want you to see it. Okay, ready? We're going to press PB2 again. Okay, can you see it? It is shifting to the output B. Next, press it again. Shift to the C. Press it again. Shift to the D. Press it again. It's actually going until it reaches 15. The next, then it's going to reach 16. After that, the bit will disappear. Okay. Now, what happened if you press PB1? Then you go ahead and press PB2. You turn PB2 off. You press again PB2. You're going to have two bit registered into the shift register. Then you go ahead and close this push button. Now, just keep playing PB2. You see, you are shifting two bits to the left or to the right. Shift again. Shift again. And shift again. Okay, now you've known the basics. Okay, let's say you are trying to make this without pressing the PB2 repeatedly. Okay, you can do. Okay, you can insert a clock pulse. Here. Let's just say I insert a 1 second clock pulse. So you go ahead and change this to be 1 second. Clock pulse, okay, and I'm going to simulate this. Okay, right now I want you to see the 1 second clock pulse right here. The 1 second clock pulse is giving beats after beats after beats after beats after beats. I'm sorry, not after beats, after pulse after pulse. Okay, now I want you to reset the whole shift register and make this clear zero. Next, just press and release the push button 1. I don't want you to press and then wait for a while and then release. No, I want you to press and release push button 1 immediately. Okay, let's see. Okay, I'm going to push and release the push button. And I want you to see the output at A, B, C, and D. Okay, here we go. Okay, you see that? I hope you understand what I'm trying to prove here. The shift register is actually registering one bit registered by the data and being shifted to the next bit, to the next data channel inside one word by the clock pulse or by the push button or whatsoever you're going to activate it. Okay, and you're going to have to reset it once you finish everything. So I hope you understand what I'm trying to say here, and I hope you forgive me for my grammar and my English. I hope this video helps you a lot. Thank you.